effectively and legally, the United States is a corporation and its judiciary operates under emergency international maritime law. And hence, the gold fringe around the flag in the form of our public notice, right? So the date is February the 21st, 1871. And the 41st Congress is in session. What did he say? He said, I'll call your attention to the acts of the 41st Congress, Section 34, Section 3, Chapters 61 and 62. They say on this date, in the history of our nation, Congress passed an act titled an act to provide a government for the District of Columbia. And so, brothers and sisters, this is also known as the Act of 1871. Write that down. See, I give you proof and tell you where and go and get it. Write that down. The Act of 1871. What does this mean, brothers and sisters? The Legislative Act of February the 21st, 1871, Congress chartered a federal company entitled the United States, a.k.a. USA, and the USA Inc. Incorporated. 28 U.S.C. 3002, subsection 15A. Well, Tazadaq, what does that mean? Well, it means that Congress, under no constitutional authority to do so, created a separate form of government for the District of Columbia, which is a 10-square-mile parcel of land. And this is our legislative democracy? So parents unknowingly have been registering their newborn children as property. Now you think it's funny all you want to, man. You think I'm crazy all you want to, but you know what I challenge you? Go and look up everything I'm saying. I won't seem so crazy anymore. Yeah, they write me off as the foolish guy. And you got people like Jonah, man, you don't know what you're talking about, man. You may give people a little remedy, but don't try and attack the secure creditor process. People just put the party in there because they say you're securing your party. You don't understand this, man. You came out of more science. Well, it has nothing to do with this, man. But stop trying to make it seem ridiculous, boy. And listen to what I'm saying, or you just might learn something. Come on, Tazadaq. This is Tazadaq doctrine. That's how we want it. So parents unknowingly, and only you have birth certificates, but you're telling people you don't need to be a secure party creditor. A birth certificate is a contract. A social security card is a contract. Your job application is a contract. The 1040 is a contract. And contracts are designed for specific reasons. So you're operating in a legislative democracy as an incompetent ward of the state. And these parents have unknowingly have been registering their newborn children as property, a thing which is domiciled or controlled by the law of private corporations, primarily the private corporation. A shout out to the original man for the donation, man. Primarily a private corporation, man, not the de jure republic formed by the Declaration of Independence and the Constitution of the Republic. Now, since the United States is in fact a corporation, 28 U.S.C. 3002, subsection 15A, as many times as I've repeated that over the years, I know all of you have heard of that. What is the main purpose of any corporation, folks? You got to stop and ask yourself these questions. What is the main purpose of any corporation? To manage an endeavor in order to achieve profits, right? Now, over the last century, war has proven to be the most profitable business in which to be engaged is war. So today, more than ever before, we have perpetual war against an enemy we cannot find. What does the scripture say? For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principality, spiritual wickedness in high places. This is what the scriptures was talking about, man. It prophesied this. Y'all know what I'm talking about, man. Can I get an amen? So you're trying to fight physical in a spiritual fight, but you better go back and remember Ephesians 6 and 12. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness. They do things in secrecy. They're Masonic handshakes, Illuminati gestures. That's in darkness, man. Of this world. Darkness of this world. Against spiritual wickedness in high places. Stop it. You're trying to fight physical in a spiritual fight. This is spiritual. And you ain't going nowhere without that Ruach HaKadosh, man. If you're not operating in the spirit of the Ruach, they're going to get you. And they will destroy you. Understand? And so since the United States is in fact a corporation, again, I ask you, I want you to think, brothers and sisters, I don't teach you what to think, like some people try and do, like college, universities, they institutionalize you. And if you don't comply with the curriculum, they tell you that you're wrong. That's not teaching you how to think. It teaches you what to think. See, I teach you how to think so that you could think for yourself outside of the box. So today more than ever before, we have a perpetual war against an enemy we cannot seem to find. And there is no one country the enemy calls home. Appreciate the donation. So the new class of citizens were given the right to vote. Democracy. Democracy. In 1870, by way of the 15th Amendment. Now stop me where I'm lying at. I'm giving you all the reference points. I want you guys to prove me wrong. All that is required is an application. Application. Application means to apply. Think. I want you to use your brain. I want you to teach you how to think. Application means you're applying for something, right? So if I'm applying for something, I have to get that something from someone of higher authority. Well, so I don't have a right to vote because I'm filling out an application and I have to fill out a voter's registration card. When you look up the word register, it means to surrender title, surrender ownership. So the way that you've been taught to think of registration in common parlance is not exactly what it really means. So if I register something, you register your sons and daughters for school. You surrender ownership. You surrender title. So CPS could come in and take your children, man. Some of you under the sounds of my voice right now, you've had your children taken away by CPS because you don't have a title to them. They have it. It's called the birth certificate. The birth certificate is not yours. It belongs to them. That's why a lot of people going and doing authentication of the birth certificate, they don't even understand why they're doing it. They think they're doing it for a secure party creditor. That has nothing to do with the secure party creditor process. It's for you to get control over that. Because since it's created in a name that sounds similar to yours, you have more right to it than anyone. Do you understand? Excuse my passion, but I have a tendency to get very passionate about this. To stress my point.